Hey everyone, I just wanted to do a real fast recap. We do this every time that we get to a new era of Disney movies, and right now we've just finished up the Bronze Age. I thought this was a great time for us to talk about each category. We've already done storyline. Today, we're going to do the music of every Disney movie that was released before 1989. Let's get talking about Disney movies music. The first movie that we're going to talk about today, of course, is Snow White. Snow White's music was a little bit confusing for me. First of all, just the time period has some weird things in it, I think. The prince sounds like he's like 40 years old. Snow White herself sounds kind of Betty Boop-like, but it's still pretty decent music, and the background music is lovely for it. I gave the music for Snow White a best rating right smack dab in the middle of the best rating. The next movie is Pinocchio, and I thought that Pinocchio was a much better movie as far as music goes in comparison to Snow White. It has some fun little things that it does, like with clocks and other bubbles and things like that, that make a little bit of just some creative uses of music and of sound in this movie. I gave it one better than Snow White for Pinocchio in the best rating. Fantasia, I thought, had beautiful music in it, but I don't really think it's an incredible form of music. I was a little bit surprised that it wasn't more beautiful. I guess it was meant to be more of a concert, and that's the way it worked. But I also think that often the music dictates where the animation should be, which I thought was a little bit weird. I didn't absolutely hate Fantasia, but it received right smack dab in the middle of the entire thing, so it got a meh rating for me. Dumbo clearly has some beautiful music in it, and it definitely has some emotional music. Especially Baby Mine is particularly an emotional song. But that doesn't mean that I thought that Dumbo's music was the best that it can be. The problem with Dumbo is just all the way around. It's so simple. I gave Dumbo almost the end of the meh rating. Bambi, I think, has incredible music. It does a lot with like setting the scene, and it also does a lot of motif in the music for Bambi. There are many times when you see like Bambi learning, and you hear one type of song for Bambi learning, and then that same song is repeated the next year when he's learning a new lesson. You see that happen over and over again. So I gave it a little bit lower than Snow White. It's still in the best category, just a little bit lower than right smack dab in the middle. The next movie was Saludos Amigos. And if there is a place where the packaged films shine, it's in music. That doesn't mean that I always liked the music, but it's much better in music than it is anywhere else. So for Saludos Amigos, though, I felt like it was very stereotypical music. I didn't feel like it was particularly well done, and there were several songs that I thought were quite annoying. I gave it the back end of the worst rating for music. The next movie was Three Caballeros, and I felt like Three Caballeros was in the same boat as Saludos Amigos. As I have said before, anyway, that Saludos Amigos and Three Caballeros are kind of the same movie. Kind of seems like Saludos Amigos was a bit of a mistake, and then they corrected it with Three Caballeros. Three Caballeros music gets one better than Saludos Amigos. Make Mine Music, I thought, had a meh rating. It was music that I thought was okay. Much more contemporary style music overall. And I gave it the top end of the meh rating for Make Mine Music. Fun and Fancy Free, on the other hand, is one of my most hated movies, and I hated the music in it also. I gave it second to last place in the worst category. Melody Time is a movie that has quite a few lovely parts in it. I liked it a lot more than I even thought I would. Melody Time, I gave the low end of the best rating. The Adventures of Ichabod and Mr. Toad has some very pretty music in it, and it has good atmosphere in it overall. But if there was going to be one part that I thought was the worst part of Ichabod and Mr. Toad, it was the music. I gave the music of Ichabod and Mr. Toad the worst rating. I love the music of Cinderella. It's memorable. It's fun to sing along to, and it has some beautiful parts in it. It also just adds to the romantic feel of the movie altogether. I gave the music of Cinderella first place out of all of the movies. The music of Alice in Wonderland definitely has purpose to it. It wants to set apart what kind of a weird world Alice lives in, or is in her dream, depending on how you want to phrase it. Alice in Wonderland, I gave the meh rating to, but I still like the music of Alice in Wonderland. The next movie is Peter Pan. Peter Pan and Alice in Wonderland usually go hand in hand, but in this case, Peter Pan is actually quite a bit higher. I thought that the music of Peter Pan did a really good job of solidifying what the characters were and who the characters were. It also has a bit of an operatic vibe to it. If there's a smile in your heart, and then you'll hear do 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 do, and I like that. And it makes the Renaissance movies that much more sweeter when you realize that they were kind of just capitalizing on history's past when they decided to make musicals. So I like that a lot. It's a fun theater dork thing for me. The next movie was Lady and the Tramp, and I'm not sure where I put Lady and the Tramp. Let's see here. I gave Lady and the Tramp second place for music in the best category. Lady and the Tramp is one of those movies that I think was done incredibly well for a lot of different reasons. A lot of that, of course, because it always has to do with this, is character development. I do love the way that the music developed the characters and helped us to understand them better, although I don't feel like this music was better than the animation of Lady and the Tramp. The music in Sleeping Beauty is pretty good, I think. The problem with it is that it has some stilted moments to it. Once again, I feel like we kind of have the Fantasia effect with Sleeping Beauty, where it feels like the music dictates what the animation or what the characters were supposed to do, rather than the music being a supporting player to help the animation look and sound its best. So often there are times when it feels like they kind of crammed in the lyrics. Health to the princess, wealth to the princess, long live the princess Aurora. Feels very much like these people are subservient to the king and queen, which obviously, of course, they are because they're the king and queen, but I'm just not a fan of it. Let's just say that. I gave Sleeping Beauty one step up from Fantasia right in the meh rating. 101 Dalmatians, I gave the high end of the meh rating to. Once again, I don't feel like the music is like the best part of it. There is the whole like diegetic side to it where Roger is creating music and he's like has the song that he sings with Cruella de Vil, and he's got his little, we'll have a Dalmatian plantation, but there's not a lot of singing in 101 Dalmatians. That may be a boon for a lot of people where they really think, wow, that's better because I don't like musicals. For me, I really love musicals, so it's probably not the best part of 101 Dalmatians for me. The next movie is Sword in the Stone, and I have never hated any movie more than I have hated Sword of the Stone. Sword in the Stone is the worst movie in any possible way. When they sing that like song when all the books come to life, it's an awful song. They sing songs where it's when they're fish and they're learning lessons that mean nothing to the overall story arc, and I hate Sword in the Stone. I burn it, leave it alone, never watch it. It needs to go away. We need to give it the Song of the South treatment. I don't want to look at it anymore. And I did really like The Jungle Book. It has a meh rating. Again, it's a lot like 101 Dalmatians, and it's rated right between 101 Dalmatians and Sleeping Beauty. I think that's fitting for it. It's got fun music to it, but it's nothing that's really going to stand out or really going to inform who the characters are in that movie in a particular way. As far as the Aristocats goes, there's two different sides to the music, which I think does inform the mood of the movie very well. And it's that you have like the rich side, the bourgeois side, and you have the hipster cat side. So you can kind of tell where you are in the story based on when you're hearing like classical style music and when you're hearing everybody wants to be a cat. It got the high end of the worst rating. The next movie was Robin Hood. Robin Hood has a decent soundtrack to it, but it doesn't have the most memorable songs to it. I thought that what it had was fine. It's just nothing that's too spectacular, but I did give it the low end of the best rating. I think that Winnie the Pooh, actually, now that I look at this, in my head, as I remember it, I would give Winnie the Pooh a higher rating. Winnie the Pooh, I put as a meh rating, the lower end of the meh rating, and I would put that up as high as Robin Hood for me. Because I do think it does a really good job of explaining who the characters are. You can often hear even Christopher Robin singing with the other characters, singing, I am a little black rain cloud, and you can hear him imagining with his toys, like what the toys are doing. I did not think that the Rescuers had the best music in it. They do have the like R-E-S-P-E-C-P-E-C-T. That can't be it, can it? R-E-S-P-E-C-T. It's not. That's not what it is. I don't remember what it is. I'm gonna leave that in anyway. It has some simple little tunes in it, but I didn't feel like the music was anything to write home about. It wasn't particularly amazing. I gave it the worst category, right in the middle of the worst category overall. The next movie was The Fox and the Hound, and as I've said before, I was very surprised by how much I liked The Fox and the Hound. However, The Fox and the Hound in this case, I gave a very low rating to. It doesn't do much as far as music goes. And what it does do with music is like the Mama Owl. It's definitely not a movie that I'm like gung-ho about as far as music goes. I love the story itself, but the music, not so great. The Black Cauldron was a bit of a surprise for me. It's on the high rating of the worst side of it, which shows you how much I hate this movie. It did have a few moments that I thought were decent as far as musical moments go, and especially in the soundtrack. They obviously don't have any music in that movie. And I actually think that was a good choice. The problem is all the other choices they made were all terrible. You can tell really bad which movies I hate and which ones I like, can't you? That movie just doesn't have the substance behind it, I don't think, to pull off a movie without any music in it. But if they would have added more music to it, it would have just made it incredibly silly. So what they did and the way the music in the background was for the product that they gave us was at least admirable. The Great Mouse Detective is one of my favorites as far as music goes. And I gave it third place. I gave it the best rating, third place in the best rating. And the reason why it is of course because of character development, because I love watching characters be developed in many different ways, from animation to music. In this, you see the music mostly developing Radigan, and I like the way that they developed him. They created a marvelous show-stopping monster. I like that a lot. He always wants to be the center of attention. He always finds a way to put on a show, and they use music to show that he wants to entertain you while he does his dastardly deeds. And I love that. So definitely, as far as music goes, I gave this a very high rating. Oliver and Company is our last one. Oliver and Company is another one that I really just unabashedly do not like. I am going to direct you, though, over to PlayCONtent right now for his review, because he absolutely loved Oliver and Company and made a review about it. So I'm going to tell you, go check out his content, especially if you are one of those people that down in the comments was like, I hate anyone who doesn't like Oliver and Company, because I mean, fair. Okay. It's fine, but you'll like PlayCONtent stuff. So go check it out. I'll put his stuff down in my description. It's definitely not a movie that I like. But it does have a couple of fun songs like Why Should I Worry? Squeaky Chair. It's got a few fun bops to it. So there we go. Now, if you guys tell me what you think about it, tell me, am I wrong? Am I right? Also, happy 4th of July, everybody. Yay! Happy 4th of July. I hope everybody's staying healthy. I'll see you again in another couple days. Bye.